Greetings, friends. David Marks here. Adobe quietly slipped a new feature into a recent Lightroom Classic update that I really like. With the June 2023 update, we can now add targeted grain into our black and white images using Lightroom's incredible masking tools. If the look of film grain with precision interests you, then let's jump right in and let's get started. Before I started recording this tutorial, I converted this photo of a lighthouse on the coast of Maine from a color image into a black and white, and I added a mask to put more contrast and drama into the sky. At this point, I'm pleased with the overall image, but this lacks the feel of a true black and white. If my goal here is to create something that looks like it was actually captured using black and white film, then the missing element is grain. As you may know, we have had the ability to add a simulated grainy texture for many years using this slider down here in the Global Effects panel. For many years, adding grain this way has been fine, but we now have a better method. Instead of using the grain slider down here in the Global Effects panel, I'm going to open up the Masking panel. And now, I'm going to create a second mask using the Select Sky command. This time, I'm going to go down to the Effects panel inside of the Masking controls, and then I'll move the new Localized Grain Amount slider up. If I set this one to about plus 50, then we get something similar to what we saw a minute ago. But this time, the additional grain is only targeting the sky. Let me lower the grain size and back off just a little in the amount. There we go. Now the sky looks perfect. So let's add one more mask to finish things off. Only this time, I'm going to use the Select Subject command. And now I can dial in the grain that I want for this specific part of the image. I need to point out that Adobe has done something that some will find very puzzling here. With this new feature, we can adjust the amount of grain on a mask-by-mask basis, but if I change either the size or the roughness, then I'm altering that quality of the grains throughout the entire image. I don't work for Adobe, so I can't tell you why they design things this way. Maybe it's a programming issue. Or maybe their engineers thought that allowing us to have one style of grain in part of the photo and another style elsewhere would look totally weird. Regardless, I'm happy enough with the ability to vary the amount of grain throughout my image using the amount slider only, even if I have to stick with a single choice for the size and the roughness. To my eyes, the addition of grain is the secret sauce that makes this digital conversion feel more like a true black and white. Let me hide my panels away, and then let me split the screen so that you can see a side-by-side comparison of this image with and without the grain. It's not a huge difference, but the image on the right, our finished product, to me it looks more realistic, and that textured feel that the grain adds, it's the perfect finishing touch. I've got one more example to share with you today. I have a very minimalist shot of two surfers on a foggy beach. Once again, I have already converted my original full-color RAW file into a black and white. This time, though, I want to add that film grain look using a very different masking trick. For the grain, I'm going to open up the masking panel. But this time, instead of selecting the sky or my subject, I'm going to create a luminance range selection. In here, I'm going to set my control points so that this mask will affect everything with a luminance value of about 10 up to about 85. And I'll allow the spillover to stretch all the way from 0 to 100. Next, I'm going to drop down to the effects section in the masking panel, and then I'm going to crank the grain all the way up. I'm going to do this so that it's really easy to see what I'm talking about here. And now, to make this even more clear, I'm going to change the show overlay mode to the image on black option. Then I'll turn on show overlay. What I want you to see is where the grain is going to be added into this photo. The parts of the image that are in black, those parts will remain without any grainy texture. The parts that are in white, those are the places where the grainy pattern will be visible. And this gray zone, this is where the grain pattern will fade gently away. If I zoom in, for example, up here in the sky, or down here around my surfers, then you can see, I hope, how they're not being affected by the addition of the grain. I'm doing this because visible grain in a true black and white photograph was never uniform. For those who remember the old darkroom days, perhaps you recall that film grain was not noticeable in the parts of your image that were truly paper white or inky black. By its very definition, paper white should be completely devoid of any detail, and thus that part of a true black and white image cannot possibly show film grain. Now, in all honesty, the kind of simulated grain that we're adding here is never going to fool the most keen-eyed pixel peepers. I'm never going to fool the Ansel Adams of the world. But at least I can make this photo look more like the way film behaved if I add grain using a luminance mask to control which parts of the image are going to be the most affected. Let me close the masking panel at this point, and let me split my screen so again we can see a before and after. If I zoom in here, the image on the top is what we started with. That's our original. And the one on the bottom, of course, is the one where I've added the grains. I've probably overdone it. I would probably go back and make those grains a little less strong, maybe reduce the amount, reduce their size. But it's the addition of the grain in the mid-tone, but not in the darkest darks or the brightest brights, that makes this image appear to me more like a real film black and white photo would. Well, there you go. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please subscribe to this channel and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.